All right, folks, we are back, jamming some leagues finally. Up tonight, we've got a bunch of Tron. We've got two Tron leagues into a Eldrazi Tron. Over at the list, this is a variation off of some pretty much what we expect nowadays. We've got Blast Zone, Ghost Quarter, Sanctum. I've got Urza's Factory in there, of course, because I love that card. And then we've got the Urza's Mine, Power Plant, and Tower, three forests. Of course, if you didn't want to play this factory, you could either play forest or swap when the other utility lands out. We've got four Ancient Stirrings, four Sylvan Scrying, four Sphere Stars, maps, and one Relic. We've got three Oath Stones, three Karns, one Thrag Tusk, two Worm Coils, one World Breaker, four Karns, two Ugins, two Ballistas, two Ulamogs. Now, something over in the sideboard that they have that I haven't played before, or not recently anyway, are the four Ley Lines, so I'm excited to see how they do. Then we've got two Claims, two Veils, a Warping Whale, and then we've got a pretty light package. Relic, Liquid Metal, Ensnaring, Trinisphere, Mycosynth, and Wormcoil. So, let's jump into a league with this. I'm gonna get this up into Stream Decker as well. No payoffs, and it's turn four. I think we can do better. Okay, I'm gonna keep this. We got two Tron pieces, and we've got ourselves a map. I think I'm gonna ship the star in case they do anything to us. I just realized that I rented this deck and I own it on Moto, so I don't even know why I rented it. Mine tower, so we need ourselves a power plant. Pass it over. Deck. Each player sacrifices a permanent. How rude. It's an interesting prison-y style deck. We're just not going to have any lands. At least we can get Karn Great Creator next. Nope. Baptize. Okay. This game is over. What an interesting deck. Well, we want Warping Whales for sure. I think that's it. Nothing else we really have is that useful. Well, let's see if we can form Tron before they blow up all of our lands again. This is like a really slow hand. I can't form Tron. Has Warping Whale and Stirrings to make me consider it, but I don't think that's good enough. I think this is okay. The only reason I think this is okay is because it's got a lot of lands, and there's a good chance we're just never going to form Tron. And it's got a payoff as a low, low-cost Karn, so... Cracking for scrying yet. We are still making land drops, so we don't need to. Not getting it there is unfortunate. I'm dumb. I knew they had mana types too to play around, and I just didn't play the land. How punishing. This is not a good matchup. Let's see how lucky we are. See if we still get the Tron business. Come on. Okay, come on. So unfortunate. It was coming too. That's a Stormbreath Dragon. they monster sit? Do they have a landing in monster sit? Let's scoop this one up, folks. So I don't know if you guys saw this for the top eight for GP Columbus. It was a pretty interesting split down the middle with Urza, Tron, Humans, and Burn. So nice to see that Humans is back on the rise. Same with Burn, I'm impressed with that they're putting up these numbers. I was there, did not do as well as I wanted. Ship that and that. Missed day two on the winning in. Time frame again. Pretty good at doing that lately. Did it for the invitation one, did it for Columbus. We're seeing if we can turn this around. Ooh, Slunsies. Oh, that's so sad. Plus side, they're gonna whiff. Ah, they're on a one lander. Well, we're not even much either, but still. Six looks like their mana problems are over. Do we want to fetch up anything? I feel like we don't. I think we'd rather just tick up. baby. Is it just Karn? Do we stay alive? We Karn down tick, hit a Goyf. They swing at it. One short of... let's crack this first.
Awesome.
Okay. Coil. Alright, most likely they Bloodbraid hit Karn, Goyf hits us, uptick again, plant a land, and then we cast Ulamog, and hopefully that'll be game. Another Bloodbraid is scary. That worm coil. Oh, we were just dead. Unfortunate. Unfortunately, we struggled to form Tron for too long. This is great. Hopefully they don't have a turn one hand disruption. Tron. So that's pretty good. That's not good. I thought I'd play Damping Sphere right now, not Alpine Moon. Interesting, we can actually cast this next turn. Drop a Karn, drop a Leyline. It's gotta be Karn, right? Uptick on the star, pass it over. Alright. get an extra blocker, and if you want to kill it, we draw a card. I'm okay with both of those circumstances. Oof, it is. Gonna uptick again. I'm gonna drop out this ley line. Hit their third land. I don't even know if we should really play that ley line. Maybe it was better in our hands, but. Sylvan's crying, we can go get a factory. And we're just gonna have to use this Veil as a cantrip. Since we have Leyline in play now. We'll have to hold it up. On the plus side, their Bob's doing a great job of killing them. Two, three, four, five, six, seven. Well, we're in a bit of a bind because they're going to uptick and we're going to lose our Ugin. If we get another land, we can use factory though. Are we dead? Take 10. Unless they have a blood rage, then we're dead. Interesting, our opponent just gave us the ability to activate our land now. That's unfortunate. That's lethal now, though. We're not very good at this right now. Starting off strong, low two. Just how we drew it up, you know. It tried to pair us and it failed. Tron. This isn't the end of the world. We got Tron. We've got a mine. And we've got Dugan. Hopefully they don't have a kite sail. Thalia makes our life a little awkward. Are we dead though? I don't think so. Five. A floating metaphor. All right. Need them not to have back-to-back Mantis Riders. Or a Mantis Rider now. Feels like a Mantis Rider. Oh, a deputy. Okay. We're still alive. We're still in this. Don't name Ulamog. Opponent, don't name the fuck. Ow! Okay. Did they even see our hand? Did they know about the Ulamog? That's so rude. We just... Okay, can we stay alive? If I go get factory, I can make one blocker and take three still and die. Wasn't bad for a mold of three. Was not bad. I think I just want to bring in this. I think everything else is fine.
We gotta get that Tron luck back.
Those terrible rips
for our opponents. Sure. This is pretty close. Nice. Just like we drew it up. Got a noble. We minus, this is gonna die for sure. Another one drop? I'd love a blast zone right now. Oh, that's an oof. Okay. I'm gonna go get a worm coil. And just see if that's good enough. And then on this, if we go get a lattice. Get a lattice, they have to swing all out. Get a bridge, similar situation. Is it better for us just to uptick this turn? Go get the blast zone. Uptick and pass. That way they can't kill Karn and they'd have to swing. Not to the best of their ability. Sure. Hmm. of unfortunate to keep drawing lands. Alright, Dantek at 3. He's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 swingers. And then Karn would die. I think we're just going to uptick again. We can get Blast Zone up to... They can swing at Karn here for 3, but if we can get our Blast Zone up to 2, we'll be able to wipe out the majority of their board and then lock them out of the game. Yes, there. Scry for the Blast Zone seemed like the correct call. Okay. And that's game. A turn 4 Tron hand. I guess that's good enough. It might not be. It might be too slow. Probably should mulligan that hand away. Thalia is probably going to be the death of us. No, that damping sphere is the death of us. Yeah. Not very good at this league right now. I think they're trying to find us an opponent that we just don't get crushed by. I feel the same. I'm going to try a different Tron list from Adam Francie. the one that was in the Invitational Top 8. He's got some stuff in there that I wanted to try out. So. Looks to be Simicers. Double Brooding Pool. Interesting. We need a power plant. Goodbye, Karn. Start off with Glowstone. Alright, so the opponent's got Thoughtseize on top of their deck. I think we're just gonna pop this now. Potentially Thoughtseize us if they can get a black source. both left with very little. But we had a worm coil. Oh, I had to say something. And they got another Urza? This is just rude. Well, I guess we're a little rude back.
Own up on it. You got this. Gonna go to one. Nope. Debatable here, they may want to double block, but. Goose, sure. So I want to bring in the Veils. Debatably, that relic is fine, but I think that's where I want to be at. Claims as well. Yeah, actually, bring in a Warping Well. It's pretty good for getting rid of their Emery, their Urza, or their Goose. I just like Warping Wheels a lot right now.
forms Trons in a little variety of ways. It's a turn slower than we would like, but... Generate the mana this turn, so let's just dig now. Oh, you know, we should have just passed. I wanted to play around a counterspell, but it may have been better just to pass, hold up Veil. If they thought sees us, we could Veil it, and then if it's on our turn, then we would be able to get around that. Doesn't really matter right now, I suppose. So we gotta go get a blast zone. I think we're just too far behind here. Like, yeah. Try that again. This hand's so close. I'm gonna keep and ship this. They might have a rebuke, so I'm gonna run out this O stone. No, they don't. Cool. Yeah, it's flowing slowly back to me, you know. The Tron luck, it's like, hey, you're back. You're back. We want to hang out with you. Gotta get a cable for my phone. It's dying. Oop. Apologies for that. Really sorry about that, folks. Sure does feel like. Yeah, these are the hands that we're looking for. What is our opponent playing? Tempo decks, right? Well, let's go get the missing piece. You know, their deck can probably keep us off our game if they have, like, the cheap counter spells. curious if we should just go for the expedition map into more mana to get Ulamog and then also get Blast Zone. Because if we go for Karn and they just counter it, and we don't have the ability to cast Ulamog the following turn, that seems real bad for us. So I think that's where I'm going to go. Especially since they can counter it as well. So, let's go map. Sphere. Cycle Sphere. Cycle another Sphere. Opponent has drawn like infinite cards. So I feel like we're best off just running out the Blast Zone. And we'll just blow up their stuff. Attacks. I guess there's no reason to not blow it up. They might have some ninjutsu business.
not backed. We got leaked. These are some magic cards our opponents are playing. I think we've got to run out this Thrag's Husk. Subjugation. Okay. I feel like our opponent draws so many cards, it doesn't even matter that they 2-for-1 themselves constantly. Until now. They have no cards now, but up until this point. Isn't that handy? We're gonna get the Sanctum. Cast the Zulamog. And go get another Ulamog. Or just a Ballista. That'd be fine too. We just don't get little mugs. Not technically, but man, they're close.
I don't think so. I wanted to try it out though, because it seems like it's in a really good spot. But I don't think I'm on it. It's interesting to say the least. Yeah, I don't know. I played the Simic Urza deck at the GP Indy. I mean, GP Columbus yesterday, and the deck felt great. The three losses I picked up were very winnable, and I never felt like I was just out of the game. So I still would like to try the deck out. I have mixed feelings about the version with Karn in it. I want to see what the breakdowns were for the list that did well. From the GP, but you know, I play the version with Karn. I pretty much copied Dykeman's list, since I was talking to him about it the whole time, back and forth on a few different items. But oh, is this hand good enough just because it's Ballista? I don't think so. But yeah, I never felt like I was out of any game, which is really good. Like, that's a fantastic feeling to have with any of these decks. I do want to give E-tron a try, though. It seems like it's in a good spot as well. A lot of people are playing it, and it did have the highest conversion rate at the Open. I mean, not the Open, but the GP. That's sweet. That's very exciting. Yeah, for us, it seems like Jeff's going to be on, pretty certain that he's going to be on blue-white control for Pioneer. And it sounds like Nate's pretty much solidified on his list as well. He's got he only had a quick question on which version, which package he wanted to do. But it looks like he's pretty set at this point as well. So I think it's just me at this point that's the undecided individual. As per usual. There's a good chance. I don't know. Like, Legacy tournaments, I always find, like, in paper, they're kind of weird. Just because you never know what people are actually going to play. Exactly. Like, the amount of players I've talked to that, you know, they literally just go, well, we found a person that owns a Legacy deck, and that's good enough for us.
Yeah, I knew it was going to get countered by the Wanderer, but I felt like that was a worthwhile trade. They're going to slow down their clock. They can pretty much just run out Brazen Borrower again, and we can drop our O Stone. Seems like a good card to have. See if we can get this Ballista and play around. A mana leak. Yeah. I think Ballista just pretty much kills everything that they have. Good chance to have a force in their hand. Hmm. I feel like our opponent's making us work incredibly hard for this match.
Doesn't play around a mana leak right now. I think we're not in a rush or anything, so we're just gonna hold on and just keep. Okay, with the 1 point of damage. That's what we're looking for. Okay, now we should have the game wrapped up. I can't wait to Ugin'alt. I would like to put everything in play. Don't know why we're still playing upon it.
Sure. They realize they're dead.
Alright. Well, that's the first one. It's not bad. We had some bad draws, of course, and whatnot. So let's switch over to the other league.